टुडेज टॉपिक इज व्हाट इज रिस्क। रिस्क इज द अंडरलाइंग कंसेप्ट दैट फॉर्म्स द बेसिस फॉर व्हाट वी कॉल सिक्योरिटी। सिक्योरिटी इज अबाउट द मैनेजिंग द रिस्क। विदाउट एन अंडरस्टैंडिंग और द सिक्योरिटी रिस्क टू एन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन इंफॉर्मेशन एसेट्स टू मेनी और नॉट इनफ रिसोर्सेज माइट बी यूज्ड। Risk is the potential for loss that requires protection. If there is no risk, then there is no need of security. And at risk is a concept that is barely understood by many who work in the security industry. Risk is better understood in the insurance industry. For example, a person purchases the insurance. The person may have a car accident that requires a significant repair works. So insurance reduces the risk of the money to repair that car. So if we look closely at this example, we see the two components of the risk. First is the money needed for the repair. So the insurance company needs to pay this amount if an accident occurs. So this is the vulnerability of insurance company. And the second component is the person to get into an accident. This is the threat that we will cause the vulnerability to be exploited. So what is vulnerability? A vulnerability is a potential avenue of attack. It may exist in computer system or networks or in administrative procedures. A vulnerability is characterized by the difficulty and the level of technical skills that is required to exploit it. So this is the relationship between vulnerability and threat. As we will see here, the vulnerability is having three level, low, medium and high, and the threat is also having three level, low, medium and high. So we have seen here the curve of vulnerability and the threat. So this shows the relationship between vulnerability and threat. So here there is a low risk, here there is a medium risk, and there is a high risk here. Okay, then threat. A threat is an action or event that might violate the security of an information system. So there are three components of the threat, that is targets, agents and events. So targets means the aspect of security that is being attacked. So it may be your confidentiality, then integrity, availability and accountability. Confidentiality means when the information is leaked of the organization. Integrity means gives the authority to change the information. Availability means the information is available to the attacker, or denial of service attack. And accountability is rarely targeted as an end unto itself. Agents of threat are the people who may wish to do harm to an organization. Okay, means we can't call it as an attacker or hacker. So access means the agent wants to access the information or any computer system or any data that is stored on the computer system. Knowledge, the level and type of information an agent has about the target. So the knowledge, in knowledge it may be user ID of the employee, password of the employee, location of the files, physical access procedures, names of the employees, access phone numbers, network addresses and security procedures. Motivation. An agent requires the motivation to act against the target. So there are various motivation, as we have seen in the last lecture also. So the motivations are challenges. The agent may accept the challenges of his friends or anybody. Greed, desire for gain. So it may be in terms of money, good or services or information. And malicious intent means a desire to harm an organization or an individual. So there are various events in which an agent or threat may cause the harm to an organization. So that events may be a misuse of authorized access of information, malicious alteration of information, accident alteration of information, malicious destruction of information. There are various events, theft of hardware or introduction of malicious software, natural physical events that may interfere with system or operation. So there are various events that are performed by the agents. So the threat plus vulnerability is equal to risk. So risk is the combination of the threat and vulnerability. Threats without vulnerability pose no risk. So the risk can be defined in three levels: low, medium and high. Okay, in the next section we will see identifying the risks to an organization.